We will now be joined by Dr. Maria Luisa Ricci, Director of the National Reference Laboratory for Legionella in Italy, and a senior researcher at the National Institutes of Health. She is also chairperson of the ESCLI Executive Committee and the author of numerous publications. Thank you, Dr. Ricci.
Good afternoon, everybody. And thank you also from my part for the organizers of the meeting to invite me, and also to IDEX that give me the possibility to do this study and to present you this data. As we well know, Legionella testing is relevant for all the actions that are aimed to assess and manage the risk in a water system according to the most international guidelines. And in Europe, starting from 2023, member states, according to the new Drinking Water Directive, must check and assess the risk for Legionella in domestic water system of priority premises. On Friday, we will have a section dedicated to this topic, where we shown how different member states have transposed these guidelines. Michelle mentioned before, the golden standard for Legionella detection and enumeration is still the culture plate method, according to the ISO 11731. And at the beginning, when this method was published, it seems a quite revolutionary one, because depending on the sample to be analyzed, the laboratory has the freedom to choose which method, which procedure can adopt, that will depend on the contamination of the sample, the laboratory experience, the limit of detection required. However, all this aspect, although seems quite good, they have they represent a great weakness of the method, because the same sample can be analyzed by different procedures. In fact, adopting the decision matrix of the ISO 11731, we can choose 14 procedures. Another limitation of this method that probably many people don't know is in the scope of the standard itself, where it's clearly stated that the method does not recover all Legionella species. About the advantages and disadvantages of the plate culture method, I think that you knows very well, you know very well these aspects. Anyway, the advantages are the detection of living cells, the identification on single cell group and species, useful for molecular typing. Among the disadvantages, we have many. First of all, the time consuming, the inhibition due to the glycine and antibiotics when selective media are used. The VBNC and Legionella intraviva are not detected. Legionella can be stressed and lost during the process, and the colony recognition require experience. On the contrary, the liquid rapid culture LegioAlert is able to simplify and shorten the analysis for the detection and quantification of Legionella. Among the advantages, we have many. First of all, we have the decrease of the volume that must be, can be tested. We can test 10 on 100 ml of potable water. Filtration is not required, as well as plating, identification, and treatment. For the reduction of incubation time is also to 7 days compared to the 10 of plate culture, reducing quality control and recovery Legionella pneumophila for serogroup identification and typing analysis. With this method we can test also non-potable water, testing only one ml of water. In this case it's necessary the treatment, a fixed treatment that is provided directly from the kit. Another important thing of this method is that it is validated by AFNOR when using 100 ml and 1 ml for non-potable water. And this was this happened in 2019. Among the disadvantages, we have the detection of only Legionella pneumophila, all serogroups, and VBNC and intramoeba also in this case are not detected. The aims of this study was to compare plate culture according to the ISO 11731 versus liquid rapid culture method, LegioAlert, using both 10 and 100 ml protocols. In addition, we compare also the capability to recover Legionella using GVPC and BCYE. In this study participated 34 laboratories accredited from the 20 Italian regions. A training session was conducted virtually for each participating laboratory. The trial was overseen by experts in microbiology, statistics, and the data, the comparison of the method was carried out in our institute in Rome. Each laboratory analyzed by about 25 drinking water samples collected from different premises, such as hospital, accommodation site, houses. For the plate culture, we used 1 liter of drinking water that was filtered by washing procedure, and the concentrate was untreated, heat-treated, and acid-treated, using both BCYE and GVPC agar plates. The liquid rapid culture method was used with LegioAlert, of course, and 10 ml, we had 10 ml, 272 sample tested with 10 ml, and 717 samples were tested with 100 ml. The data analysis was conducted both statistically and graphically, according with the ISO 17994, 2017, that assess the compatibility between alternative method and reference method. Here are the comparison we performed, the 10 and 100 ml Legionella protocols were compared both with BCYE and GVPC, and GVPC was compared with the BCYE. Here are the results obtained according to the ISO 17994. And as you can see, LegioAlert has always, almost always, a higher sensitivity compared to the culture. Only in one case, when 100 ml was tested versus GVPC, we had statistically inconclusive results. This is, was analyzed according with this norm that I want to just to show you on the right side of the slide, the key features of this norm that are that when the upper and lower limits of the confidence interval are respectively between minus 10% and zero, and the upper limit was between zero and plus 10%, the method does not differ. If the lower limit is greater than zero or the upper limit is less than zero, the methods are different. Furthermore, the smaller is the amplitude of this confidence interval, the greater is the confidence of the statistical output. This is the graphical representation of the data we obtained, and as you can see, the mean relative difference of all comparison is above zero. This is the red dot in the graphics. In the graphic, only for the comparison of GVPC, of Legerath with GVPC, we obtained that the lower limit is below zero. So this could be the reason of this result could be due to the necessity to have more data pair to obtain a good statistical significance of this comparison in favor of Legerath. However, the mean relative difference greater than zero, we can also say that the Legerath is more sensitive compared to culture. These are the results in detail. I want just to show you that in the case when we use the 10 ml in comparison with the two media, we obtained a quite wide lower and upper limit of the of this comparison, and this is probably due to the large multiplication factor employed to convert these results in counts per liter that produce these artifacts. On the contrary, when we tested 100 ml water samples, the interval of confidence is more restricted. That means that the results is more significant, with exception, as I told you before, with the comparison of Legerath with GVPC. In this case, we need to increase the sample and to reanalyze the data. In summary, based on the data and the statistical analysis we performed, it would appear that Legerath is a suitable and alternative method to the ISO 11731. For the enumeration of Legionella pneumophila in potable sample. The 100 ml protocol would appear the most suitable one due to the greater sensitivity and the reduced error from the dilution. Finally, I want to do some consideration about the Legionella testing and Legionella pneumophila testing. And this is in particular referred to Legerath, that as I told, as you know, and as also Michelle told you before, is able to detect only Legionella pneumophila. Legionella pneumophila represents the species most involved in Legionella disease cases, as well documented by the annual report of ECDC. And the scientific community, in my opinion, should become aware of this greater risk compared to the other Legionella species. This could be a great opportunity to, especially in the transposition of the New Drinking Water Directive, to focalize the attention in Legionella promophila, making this testing more frequently, frequently compared to the other Legionella species. That could be tested in less frequency. This is particularly true for premises where people do not have Legionella disease risk, high Legionella disease risk factors. In this case, health authorities should focus the attention, major attention in Legionella promophila and testing more frequently, also by using LegioAlert. That, as I showed you before, is a quite simple and easy test. The detection of other species could be performed over a longer interval, for example, for this kind of premises every 2 years, and risk-based approach could be very could be obtain precious contribution in decreasing the incidence of Legionella disease and also in saving money and time. I want to thank a lot to IDEX providing testing material for this study, but not less to all the people involved in this great study. And on the 34, really was 34 participating laboratories, because here we didn't consider our laboratory that the same analyzed the sample. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Ricci.